It was an exciting day in central Alabama as the annular solar eclipse made its appearance. WVTM 13's Emma Owen explains how one Hoover school soaked in this rare sight.
Equipped with these special safety glasses, students and families are here at River Chase Elementary ready to get a peek at this partial solar eclipse. Students attending Saturday's solar eclipse watch party enjoyed sweet treats as they stared at the sun's rays. Here in Alabama, nearly 60% of the sunshine was removed as the moon passed between the earth and the sun, a sight classmates enjoyed together.
I saw the moon covering the sun.
It just looked like a very bright cookie that had like a bite taken out of it.
Emmett Middleton says it was cool seeing the annular eclipse, especially since the last total solar eclipse we had was in 2017. Michelle Wooten, assistant professor of astronomy education in the Department of Physics at UAB, explains how the two are different.
In an annular eclipse, the moon is a little bit further away from the Earth, and so it doesn't completely cover the sun. There is a path through the United States that will see the moon completely in front of the sun, but they'll also see a ring around the sun.
According to WVTM 13 meteorologist Adrian Castellano, the next total solar eclipse is expected in April 2024.
And like what we saw in Tennessee, during the last total solar eclipse, it will become dark for a while as that happens. Here, again, we're going to not be in the path of 100%, but still you'll get that effect where it becomes a little darker, a little dimmer in the sky.
And when April rolls around, the kids at River Chase Elementary say they'll be ready. In Hoover, Emma Owen, WVTM 13.